Flowers vanish at son's grave, so dad hides camera. She couldn't believe it. Could someone really have the audacity to do this? It wasn't just about how it made her feel, it was about their son. How dare they take the things that she brought to him? Her husband was just as surprised as her. They had to think of a way to catch the culprit. But when they finally watched the secret recording, their jaws came unhinged. Michael and Ellen Wright lived in Oklahoma with their two children. They felt like their lives were going exactly as planned. They had met the person they wanted to spend their life with, got married, and had two beautiful children. And when Ellen got pregnant with their third child, they couldn't contain their joy. But things wouldn't end as they had hoped. After waiting until Ellen was 3 months into her pregnancy, the Wrights told their friends and family the good news, and everyone was over the moon. Ellen was ecstatic. But not long after, the couple's happiness was cruelly ripped away. After carrying their unborn son for 9 months, they tragically lost him at birth. They mourned their son, who they had named Gabe, and decided to give him the burial he deserved. The couple spared no expense for their son's burial. They got a beautiful plaque that read Gabe Wright, son of Michael and Ellen Wright. The plaque was also engraved with an ornate cross. It dulled the pain somewhat to feel that they had done right by their son and had been good parents in the one act they could do for him. But there was one thing that they hadn't considered. Before they would invite their children to come to honor their sibling's memory, Michael and Ellen felt that they wanted some alone time with him first. The couple held each other and honored their son's memory together. Every time they visited, Michael would clean the plaque and Ellen would replace the wilted flowers. But strangely, this time the flowers from last week were missing. Ellen replaced them, never suspecting that this particular cemetery was harboring a secret that nobody in the community knew anything about. Every time Michael and Ellen visited Gabe, they were touched by how many more visitors had left toys behind in memory of their son. Although Gabe would never get to play with these gifts, the Wrights appreciated the gesture of support from the community. Visitors left behind flags, pinwheels, and other little toys. However, it wasn't long before they noticed something very disturbing. Visiting Gabe's grave every week helped the mourning parents cope. They decided it was time to bring their children, and even the family dog, to show Gabe, wherever he was, that he was still a very important part of their lives. They let their children play some of their favorite toys on Gabe's grave to show him they were still his siblings and that they loved him. They said goodbye and promised they'd visit next week. But they could never have imagined what they'd see when they came back. The next time the Wright family visited Gabe, Ellen was shocked. Where, just a week before there had been flowers and mementos from her children, there was nothing. The flags, pinwheels, stuffed toys, they were all gone. But who had taken them, and why? Ellen couldn't believe that someone would do this. With all her pain and anger rising to the surface, she knew she had to catch the culprit. Michael held his wife and assured her that he'd do whatever it took to find out what had happened to their son's gifts. A million thoughts flooded his mind. Maybe curious animals like raccoons had come into the cemetery and taken them? Maybe it was against the cemetery's policies to leave things on the graves? Whatever the reason, he'd figure it out. With all of the innocent explanations that ran through Michael's mind, there was one that he couldn't shake. And this one was more sinister. He hoped that it wasn't true, but one thought dawned on him that made shivers go up and down his spine. Even with the general sanctity that cemeteries possess, Michael had once read an article about someone who had the audacity to steal things from the graves of grieving families. He just hoped he was wrong. There was only one way to find out. The cemetery didn't have any security cameras, so Michael would have to leave his own setup to catch the grave robber. But he didn't want the thief, or someone else, to see his camera and steal that too. It would just be another loss for them, and another win for the thief. Michael knew the only way to catch the culprit was to hatch an ingenious plan. Michael got a small camera without any kind of light that would alert the thief. He painted it brown and hid it in the bushes so no one would notice it. Now, he just had to wait. But after waiting a week and reviewing the footage, Michael couldn't believe what he was looking at. There was his son's grave, and there was the culprit, the reason why the toys and flowers were missing. And it wasn't what he had expected at all. Michael called for Ellen to look at the footage and confirm what he was looking at. She raced in, eager to find out what had happened to the gifts they'd left their son. But she wasn't prepared for what she was about to see. In the footage, the culprit is seen snuffling among the toys laid on Gabe's grave. Then, the dog, obviously astray, quietly takes them away one by one. Ellen's heart broke at the sight. Was the dog living there on its own? They had to find out. Michael and Ellen returned to the cemetery the next day, and sure enough, all the toys were gone. But there was no sign of the dog anywhere. With their anger over the missing toys forgotten, they were determined to find it and help if they could. Ellen began to walk in a wide circle around Gabe's grave. Suddenly, she heard a noise. When she got close to where she thought the noise had come from, she didn't really know what she was hoping to find. But as she made her way around the stones to an older part of the cemetery, she saw a massive hole under one of the gravestones. From afar, the hole looked like it had been hollowed out, but still had some brown sand inside. Until she got closer and realized that was not dirt. The dog was huddled under a pile of soil that it must have dug itself. The dog looked petrified when it saw Ellen and made itself even smaller by moving even deeper into the hole. Ellen was stunned. What was a dog doing here? She knew it was not uncommon for dogs to mourn their owners, but this dog had made itself a den filled with Gabe's toys. She called for Michael. Ellen tried to make it come out of the hole by whistling and calling it, but it was clear that the dog was not going to move. No one knew how long this poor dog had been there, or if it had had water or food. Was this dog that had been stealing Gabe's mementos mourning its owner? After a long while, the dog seemed to be intrigued by Ellen's soothing voice. It briefly came out of the hole to introduce itself. But as soon as it came out, it doubled back and checked on something before going any further. What was this dog hiding? Soon, they would find out. As the dog made way for Ellen and Michael to see what was inside the hole, they couldn't believe her eyes. This dog was not mourning her owner, but protecting her babies. The stray mama had a little cave under the gravestone that she'd filled with toys and had her puppies in there. Ellen couldn't believe what she was witnessing. This poor dog was just looking out for her babies and dug herself into somewhere she thought was safe. She had surrounded her puppies with comforting toys and flowers, so she must have been someone's pet once. Ellen and Michael knew they needed to help her, and they were prepared to do anything in their power to do just that. "You can see the den she created and just how compact it was," Ellen said in an interview. "While it wasn't ideal, it was the best she could find." The pups were struggling for survival, so Michael got some dog food while Ellen waited with the dog and her pups. "The puppies were very frail and were lucky to have been found," Ellen added. The puppies and their mom were ravenous. Ellen had no idea how long this canine family had been without food or water. The mom dog was unafraid of Ellen now, and she even let her pet her. As soon as the pups smelled the food on the ground, most of them quickly wriggled toward it and wolfed it down. But some were more lively than others. Some of the little ones were too frail to even move. Ellen was now scared for them, she had to get help, so she got out her phone and called a center that she knew would be willing to help. The local NSPCA immediately took all of them in, and once she knew they were all safe, the mama dog fell into a deep sleep. The canine family had its own safe place with warm beds, fresh water, and good food they could all nibble on. All of them received expert medical attention, they all were in good health, but still needed a lot of food and rest before they could be put into the adoption program. All the pups' bellies were growing, and their fur was shining. If it was not for Ellen and Michael, who knows what would have happened to these babies? But what about all the toys the dog had stolen? Ellen, Michael, and their children picked out a few of the mementos that they wanted to return to Gabe's grave, but they all decided to let the poor dog and her pups keep the rest. The lonely mama dog was looking for some form of comfort and human connection, which she had found at Gabe's resting place, just as the Wrights had.